Hi guys, today we are learning how to multiply using a standard algorithm. The standard algorithm is the normal set of steps for solving a problem. Today we are really focused on partial products. And in order to understand partial products, the first thing that we have to understand is we have to understand place value. So when we look at the number 137 times 5, it's really important that we remember that the 7 is in the 1 spot, so its value is 7. This 3 is actually in the 10 spot, so its value is actually worth 30, not just 3. And this 1 is in the 100 spot, so its value is actually 100 and not 1. The reason that's important is because when we do partial products, we have to know the full value of the numbers. So to start off, we will always be multiplying with our 5 because that number is going to consistently go between all of these top numbers. If we had a bottom number, then we would do the same. So this is going to be 5 times the value of the 7. In this case, it's in the 1 spot, so it's 5 times 7. 5 times 7 equals 35. I'm now going to do 5 times 3. But remember, we talked about this. This 3 is actually in the 10 spot, so the value of that 3 is actually 30. You guys already know how to multiply by multiples of 10. So we're going to do 5 times 3, which equals 15, and then add 1 0. So it's 15 plus a 0. Now I'm going to do 5 times the 1. Remember, the 1 is in the 100 spot, so therefore the value of it is actually 100. And 5 times 100, again, that's pretty easy. We know 5 times 1 is 5, and we add 200, 2 0s, and so then it is going to be 500. Now this makes a pretty easy problem for us to go ahead and add up all of our partial products. So we have 5 plus 0 plus 0 equals 5. 3 plus 5 equals 8, and 1 plus 5 equals 6. So that is our final answer. Partial products is one of my favorite ways to do multi-digit multiplication because it breaks it down into easier multiplication problems. Please let me know if you have any questions.